today we are going to hack into the most common encrypted Linux computers. Hello, I'm Murer, head of CyberSec at Dextra. There are many encrypted Linux computers with unencrypted boot partition. That should be the most common case since Ubuntu installation process does that by default. So, is the setup safe? Sure, it's okay when we talk about privacy, since your data are encrypted. It should work if you have your computer stolen. However, an open boot partition can be tampered with. And today, I'm going to show you how to hack this setup by doing that. But before, we need to understand how the Linux boot process works and what is inside the boot partition. When you turn on your computer, it runs an embedded software that will start the code in EFI or MBR. Either way, it starts the bootloader. And we will talk about one called Grub. Grub loads the kernel from the boot partition and starts it. The kernel performs a lot of tasks, such as opening the encrypted partitions. Finally, the kernel starts the init program. It manages every other programs and lets the computer read to the user. There are several ways we can physically access the boot partition. The easiest way would be starting a live system on the target computer. However, some computers may block boot from media devices, like USB sticks. So, I will show you how to start it using the pre-installed Grub. And the most aggressive way would be removing the storage device from the target computer and plug it in your computer. I will not cover it since it is straightforward. Let's check if you get into the Grub screen when you start the computer. If you do not see that, try these two methods. There are three methods to boot your device using Grub. Method 1. Chain loading the EFI binary. Let's press C to get into the console and LS to list the devices. Now we chain load the EFI binary and boot. And that's it. My live Kali Linux is starting. Method 2. Chain loading the MBR boot. In this case, we need to set root to our device. Chain load it and boot. Method 3. Loading the kernel. First, let's set pager so we could see long results. Then we can print our live commands. That would make our life easier, since we can just copy the commands to load Kali. Now we copy all the commands, the setroot, Linux, init, rd, and finally boot. Let's start the root terminal and mount the boot partition. Now we need to unpack the init.rd files. So let's use binwalktool to get the exact point where the files are packed. And that's how we unpack. This is the script that asks for the encryption password. We need to get the password. And write it to the boot partition. So we will be able to read it later. Now we modify to add our super user. First, we need to generate a password. That script is executed when the file system is mounted. Let's append the user add command. Actually, we need to remount root partition as writable. And we want to change the default shell to avoid being listed on the login screen. Now we repackage the tampered initrd file. And that's it. We need to wait for the user to decrypt his computer. Our tampered kernel will get his encryption password and add our user. So, let's pretend we are the victim and boot our infected computer. As you can see, everything goes as expected, but the damage has already been done. Let's back to the hacker role. That's how you can see the encryption password. Remember, there are several ways we can read the boot partition. Now, let's boot the computer as the user usually does. I changed these two parameters so we can see the boot output. We can type the password we have just got. Let's use our new user to login. And we have root access. The attack we've just done is so basic. We could do much more. For instance, get a remote shell, break antivirus softwares, ransomwares. Keep in mind, kernel is where hackers can do almost anything. It should be clear by now how we can defend ourselves. There are two links in the video description. The Arch Linux guide of how to encrypt Linux computers. That's awesome and should work with any Linux. And a guide of mine to encrypt Ubuntu Linux boot partition. Thank you. See you on the next video.